And now it's Dino Jungle, and then we can get the hell out of here. The first thing, anyways, since we're still on Pokken for a second, the first thing I think of is just the CG intro and how good everything looks.
I
remember how good the models in general look, because I remember they had, like, proper fur and everything.
Yeah, I mean, the game was fun. I do remember having a decent amount of fun with it, but I've only really played it a couple of, like, two times at most.
I'd be willing to pull it out again if you wanted to play it.
I would have to. I've been having an issue with my Switch lately where it just keeps on, like, going online, offline constantly, so I'm gonna have to figure that out, but, yeah, I wouldn't mind playing that game again.
I think we need to talk to him. Alright, let's get this over with.
Hey, you did it! My contraption is working!
Step right. Your animation just reminds me so much of the professor, yet you're not.
Wait, it's basically just a... more, not a palette swap, but it's like, really close.
Wing shield, wing shield.
This is a...
Spyro, is he digivolving?
Yeah, basically. Yeah, again, this game does have some elements that I do like. Like, the fact that, like, every level has a different loading screen is cool. I like that. Because, like, in the other games, it was always just fly to the area and that was it, which worked fine for what it is, but I'll give this game credit for making them unique.
So, Equinox were in charge of, like, art design and stuff?
Yeah.
So why'd they get punished for this game?
I don't
have escaped from their inescapable cages and are running amok through the jungle. Please stop them before they destroy the rest of the science labs and all of our research.
No problem. But say, what's a R1000 something something?
Oh, well, to put it in simplified terms that even a dragon can understand.
Wow.
Nanotech proportion oriented riptox, which we've been working on here in our labs. Quite the state of the art, I might add. But they're very edgy.
Oh, really? And how exactly would I go about destroying these things?
Well, we did find a flaw in the R1000 models when they were exposed to sub-zero temperatures. Perhaps that information will come in useful.
No problem. I have just the right breath to chill them out.
Lol.
Great!
Ice breath, let's go.
The T-Rex 1000s are quite vulnerable to electricity. Yet we've not been able to get close enough to them to zap them with an electrical charge.
Okay. Yeah, another thing that
basically it's saying you need to use your breaths.
Yeah. Another thing I do like in this game compared to, like, 2 and 3 specifically is the fact that, like, yes, I think we talked about it before briefly, but, yes, Spyro actually talks to the NPC sometimes. It's not super often, but he still does it. Whereas, like, in 2 and 3, like, he pretty much never did that. Which is
so these must be the... So I'm guessing these are the ones that are vulnerable to ice.
Yeah, seems like
and
it.
And the big ones are the electric ones.
Yeah. At least just something, I guess. They did what they could. Yeah. Yeah, that's one thing I always like, even from just my first playthroughs. Like, that's something I always missed in Spyro 2 and 3 is the fact that, like. There was so much. Spyro had so much personality in the dragon cutscenes in 1 that the fact that, like, he doesn't really say much beyond the actual, like, cutscenes themselves, is kind of a disappointment. So I do like that they tried a bit of that in this game, at least. But yeah.
Sorry, I'm not really enthusiastic right now. I just really want to get this game over.
No, I just want this game done. I
just remember, whatever you're suffering, I'm suffering more.
Yeah.
Well, we have a tester here.
Yeah, we're gonna have to go loop around. Yeah, I do.
And if things play out correctly, that should be where we stop.
Yeah, hopefully we don't miss anything.
Oh God.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. I mean.
Yep. Time to go off tab.
Yeah. But I guess there are some things I do want to try and clear up while we're here. I did at one point talk about something about level design or something or other. And I didn't really like specify what I meant. Basically what I was trying to get at is like, even if a game has like by the numbers level design, if you will, it can still be fun. If it's simple and like a game where the level design doesn't really, well, hold on, let's get this dialogue first.
There's a cope when I like that.
Oh, that's good. And it's quite
fascinating. Oh yeah? How so? Well, I believe that these strange drawings on the walls are a clue to something hidden away in this temple. But I can't quite decipher them yet. Yes, and from what I have been able to decipher, it seems that the gems on the statues inside react to heat. Perhaps you can figure out the rest, Spyro.
Yeah.
Basically, let's see.
Yeah.
Well, first off, these are the guys who need ice.
Yeah. But yeah, I was saying though, a game can have a level design that's like, doesn't really try to break boundaries or what have you, and it can still be a fun time, but the issue with like a Spyro game doing that is the fact that like a Spyro level design that's like by the numbers basically boils down to what this game does, where it's just a lot of it is just open space with not a lot of interesting platforming or anything exciting. You just go around these big areas, and it just kind of gets monotonous. Like I've been saying.
So what you're saying is that they made the sequel to Spyro 2 you wanted.
I mean,
flame the statues.
Yeah, I'm trying to. How does this work again?
Flame the statues, I think.
I don't think that's not right, isn't it?
Well, you just said the heat.
In these, okay, is it like? I think it's like a specific order, though.
Well, let's try flaming them all and seeing what happens first.
Yeah, that'd
maybe be... try going in from gem value.
That might be
it. Yeah, the red one's green. The red one's still glowing, so.
Oh, okay. So red, green.
Red, green, blue. Yellow. No, red, green.
Blue.
Red, green, blue, yellow.
Blue's five. Blue's five.
Okay. Yeah, blue, yellow, and then purple.
Let's see if this works.
If that's the case, then I'll give them props for this.
Wait. I think the gem turned. I think it turned off.
No.
I guess it ran out. I don't know.
Go back to green. Go back to red. Let's try. Let's see. Let's look at the statues again. Green.
Red, green, blue, yellow, purple.
Yeah, it's still glowing. Are they still glowing? Yes.
Yeah.
Are they still glowing?
Nope.
No.
They all stopped glowing, so I guess it's red, blue, green, purple, yellow.
Yeah, let's try purple, yellow, and see what happens.
Yeah, I'm not really sure. Yeah, okay, I'm not really sure what
the correlation is.
Yeah, I don't know what this puzzle is meant to represent.
I guess.
Well,
just...
all I can see is gem colors.
Well, we were wrong, so it can't be that.
It's gem colors, it's just not in currency order.
Yeah, so I'm not really sure how you're supposed to figure that out.
Trial and error, that's...
I mean, at least we got it. Does the scientist say anything new?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, it's Scarlet.
No, that dragonfly is yellow, not scarlet.
Is it gonna give me a better hint? I wanna see.
It was easy as 1-2 flame.
Okay, I'll have to look back at his original dialogue, because I don't know how you're supposed to...
It reacts to heat. Maybe there was something in the room we were supposed to look for. Maybe there was a background visual.
Maybe.
I mean, because there's those, but...
Yeah, that doesn't really tell me anything.
There's only two of them.
I mean, there's only five pillars and or five. Okay.
But I mean, everything might... more on the walls.
There's stuff on the... Wait, hold on.
Oh, they have numbers next to them. Look.
Is that...
Look at that one, and then look at the purple.
Wait, does
it? Those symbols on them.
Is that a number?
No, it's not a number, but the number of symbols around them. See, that's the purple.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Alright.
So what'd the yellow have? They have five? The green has two. The green has two.
That one has like... I can't see it from over there. Whatever.
Well, look at red.
And I think there's gems on top of the statues, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean...
We'll give that one a bit more credit.
I will say, like, some of the levels have had, like, a decent enough level design, if a little bit annoying. Like, the Thieves' Den had, like, camera issues and perspective issues and, like, just not being able to see very well. But I will give these last couple of levels this. At least the level design has been at least somewhat intriguing in some ways, and it hasn't just been... like just an open space with like nothing in it, so I'll give credit where it's due, but I think the problem is, like, when you compare it to like,
oh, there's the key already.
Oh, cool.
Well, that'll make the trek around a lot easier.
Yeah, but like, yeah, the problem is that like, the type of level design because like the level design in these levels is basically what you'd see in like very early game in the trilogy, so like it's kind of sad that you like you get to the very end and it's only starting to kind of resemble what the trilogy is, and even then it's like not even close.
I didn't even see those, to be honest.
Because like, yeah, the. Like even in the early levels in like Spyro 2, and I bring up Spyro 2 because that is in my opinion the one that has like the least like exploration and platformy stuff, I guess. It's a lot more straightforward than the other ones. But even with that one, there's still a lot of intriguing level design. There's the while some of the mini games aren't the best, the majority of them at least gives you a decent challenge or in whatever they end up doing, most of them anyway. And
go for it, you know, sorry.
Yeah, and
I'm gonna puke.
yeah, what was it like this
you,
game
you
is
you all better have the shortest final thoughts. I am not standing through this footage anymore.
I mean, when we actually get to the credits, I mean, we're probably not gonna have much left to say, but yeah, it's like, I don't know. I think I more or less got my point across, but yeah, the fact that like this game, a lot of the level design is just by the numbers in a bad way. The mini games are just, I've said it before, but they're either boring, brain dead, or annoying, like, hard for really annoying reasons, or, like, a mixture of, like, some of those put together. And it's just not fun.
Was there a portal down here?
I don't know, but...
There's a way up.
Oh, yeah, and, like, The one mini game that I do enjoy, there's one over there.
There's a challenge gate too.
Yeah,
let's create a thing first before we get the challenge gate, just so we can get our way out.
The one type of challenge that I do like, with being the slide mini games. Even those have their own caveats to them because they don't control very well and the camera sucks. So it's just like, you can't win with this game.
Oh yeah, no, we'll just clear this on the way up. It's directly up, I guess. We had to reset it anyways, I think.
Okay, yeah, let's just do this first. I don't remember what this.
You like? Hey, Spyro, do you like tanks?
It better not be a tank again.
I was trying to have a joke, but
yeah.
Who knows? I know there's no more speedways.
Right. I pretty much said my piece on like the minigames in this, but do either of you have anything to add to any of that? This sucks. Wait. Oh, wait. No. Never mind. Okay. No. I was thinking of something else. This is just another slide one. Okay.
Like the music.
Yeah. This is good music.
Stuart Copeland didn't slack.
Yep. Yeah. If they just polished these sections up a bit, like these would be like a decent extensions to the game. They're just a little bit janky. Oops.
Oh gosh, slowing it down made it worse.
Yeah. Yo. All right.
All right, Spyro, we had to clone you. Your first clone papa died.
Yeah.
It's the clone machine from the Futurama video game. Do you know the bit I'm talking about?
I've never played that game.
I didn't play it either, but I've seen the cutscene. How the game literally starts is the professor said Fry to get a thing, but it kills him. But he does it intentionally because it's so he can test the cloning machine. That's basically your explanation for lives.
Remember when shows could get licensed games?
Yeah, I can't see.
Oh, I didn't even notice that was there.
Yeah, I couldn't see if that was death.
But anyways, what happened was, if there's a killed Fry, it did like a fake out game over.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
But like after the cloning machine worked, Leela asked Fry, "What was it like to die?" It was amazing. It was all black, and there were a bunch of white letters that said "Game Over."
I
crazy son.
No, I like it when the professor's just like, I've been trying to kill you to test it ever since.
That's a pretty good line.
I can't see where I'm going.
Whoa! Is that the end right there?
No, I don't think we're even halfway.
I feel like we don't get, like, crazy slide sections in games anymore.
You're right.
Yeah, that doesn't happen often. Like, I'm thinking... I think I said this in an earlier part, but... these do give me Rayman 2 vibes a little bit, because that game also had... A knack for, like, slide segments, like, what, similar to this.
This is such a PS2 kind of mission.
Yeah! Yeah, I can't think of any of... Yeah, I can't think of any other game besides this. Oh, okay, this and Rayman 2 that have stuff like this.
I could see it happening like in Ratchet and Clank or Jak and Daxter, or like Hide the Tasmanian Tiger.
I can hear the music right now of you escaping Razorbeard ship.
Yeah, right.
Wow, that was not that bad. It was a little tense, but that was not that bad.
You made it just in time, Spyro. Here. I found a dragonfly on my way down.
It was mainly the first part where I couldn't see where I was going.
Squeak took the elevator.
It seems as if the volcano has stabilized. Wanna try sliding down it again?
Nah, I'm good. At least it didn't have a second dragonfly like the other one.
wasn't that bad. That was actually kind of cool.
Yeah. This definitely gives me vibes of, like, trying to be a final level. Because, like, with how they're making us use the other, like, breaths and all that as well.
And so, you know, they're actually going to make us use the wing shield in a practical way. I know, I'm funny, but...
Yeah.
Remember to get your lightning breath out. And a few of the generators start behind us.
Yeah.
Okay, turn.
I know, is there anything about this game that we haven't discussed yet?
I don't really know, because just like... I mean, we might be commentaried out at this point.
I wanted to, like, go through all the stuff.
Wow, that's actually very, that was very easy.
Yeah, that was, like, the easiest one we've done. Whatever.
Hey, it's Karen.
Sure.
Wait,
who? Sure. we'll go with that.
Ah, Rhett, you mean Karen.
How do I get back up?
Keep going forward. No.
Wait, what?
There's a ladder over there.
Is there?
I love it. Hey, it's Karen! Wait.
Oh, okay. Eh.
I'm gonna imagine Tom Kenny saw a song that's like, whoops.
God.
Wait. Did we look on the right?
Oh, God.
Okay, no, I think we're good.
I guess more of the story, when and...
Universal sucks,
but also, when and if an actual Spyro 4, a new Spyro game in general happens, give the dev team enough time to actually make the game they want to make, and don't make it so we get another Enter the Dragonfly situation. That's all I'm gonna say.
Okay. That was too close.
Like, there's moments where I can see this being a follow-up to the trilogy, but it's...
The thing is, it might be at a left. So far, this is probably the best level.
Yeah.
I feel sick.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm never watching our Spyro game.
There's actually interesting shit going on in this level.
Yeah, that's the thing, like, we come to the end of the game and only now are we getting somewhat intriguing level design.
The kind of environmental design is actually kind of neat, too.
Yeah.
Like the light peering in from the volcano.
That is cool.
Oh, there's a thing on the left, what's that?
Ah, okay, I remember this.
Oh, it's an invisibility challenge down there.
Yeah. Oh. Can I just kill anything?
Were they not the ice?
I don't know what the ice guys are supposed to be then.
Maybe the guys in the lava?
Maybe. That might be it.
Oh gosh.
Well, then just put on electric breath, and then we'll just keep it on.
Yeah.
Oh gosh.
Yeah. Shouldn't be much, too much longer.
So, these guys are the RT-1000, right?
I guess? I don't know.
Why do they just die to any breath when they should die to ice?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, Jerry, what do you got for us?
Gosh darn it, Kogan. Blasted R-1000s destroyed my lab and ran off with my equipment!
Hello? Hey, Spyro. Say, I don't suppose you could help me get my equipment back, could you?
Sure.
Great! Thanks, Spyro! Well, you see all those R-1000s out there? Say, borrowed my equipment. All I need you to do is to get it back for me. Simple.
Oh, that's all you want me to do? And how exactly do you want me to do that? There's a lava pit out there.
Well, it just so happens that we scientists here have needed to go on to the lava also. We therefore developed these devices that you can use too. Here, let me turn it on for you. There. Now all you have to do is pass through this gateway, and you will be able to walk onto the lava without being hurt. However, Spyro, the invulnerability that you have to the lava won't last long, but you can come back and recharge if necessary.
Cool. Now it's time to go kick some Riptock butt.
Good luck to you.
Cool.
There's actually a full-blown conversation. How about that?
Yeah.
Alright, so okay. We just gotta get these guys.
Oh, so are these the guys that I need to freeze? Okay.
Yes! There we go!
Okay.
Why didn't they just spring- Oh, wait, there's a dragonfly.
Sorry. Yeah, I heard it.
Well, how many are there?
I don't know. So I enjoy, like, no anime- There's no, like, particle effects or anything.
No, yeah, the Spyro would normally turn red or something if you,
Well, not even just that, but, like, look, running on the lava, it's like, there's no effect or anything.
It might as well just be a ground.
Yeah.
It's Mitch.
Are you sure it's not Karen again?
Yeah. So I just kind of wander around. It looks like these things like look like some kind of metal Gex or something.
They're kind of fascinating to look at, to be honest. Yeah. What's the? Oh, that's the, is it the lab equipment?
Oh, oh. I dropped them. Do they? Okay.
Oh. Oh.
I see. Okay.
Well, we're gonna have to run back around. That means. Hopefully, we can find them all.
They just die into like a liquid puddle something.
Yeah, right? I think we're gonna have to run back.
There's only two.
So, there was where were they?
Should be, like, back here. I don't know if there's anything else in this area.
There's one. Is that all? Was there- where was the other one? Was it over here?
No.
Turn left.
Let's see.
Maybe it's around.
No, it's not.
Well, we're gonna have to go on a little bit of a treasure hunt. Try looking around for me on the right. No. Oh boy. Go straight.
I think I've already...
Go straight from the invincibility gate.
I don't think I've been back here.
Over there?
Yeah, this is new. Hi.
Oh! Well, good thing we went over here then.
Okay, I don't know if that is gonna... That portal is gonna reset
let's hope not, but we're gonna have to go through it anyways.
Well, first off, I'm gonna go back to the scientist guy.
You be sure?
Yeah, I don't wanna, like, risk it. I don't trust this.
At least he's not that far.
Yeah, I don't trust this game.
Fair enough. Alright, dude, here you go.
Jump, Spyro! You found them all! Here, I found this dragonfly under some broken equipment I found in my lab. You can have it!
Hey, wait!
It's Jason!
I swear we already.
Hi.
I swear we already found a Jason.
Yeah, he's right here.
Well, that too, but I'm pretty sure we found another dragonfly that was Jason, like. In, like, the ice level or something.
Maybe.
God.
No, that was Jordan.
Oh, yeah, we did find a Jordan.
And I think we found a Harry at one point, too.
I think so.
Alright, what do we got here?
If it's what I'm thinking, this might be the one that I was saying this sucks.
Alright, let's see.
Because I don't
remember what's here.
Yep, I think this is this. Yeah.
Of the tower, you will prove yourself worthy of the tower's secret treasure. Why a tower exists in the middle of the jungle is a secret hidden away ages ago.
Yep.
This is just a giant climb tower.
Yeah, and I remember this being extremely irritating.
So it's just a big climb challenge.
Yeah.
What's next? They're gonna sink? Looks too scary.
watch for rolling rocks. Spiders up there too. Just avoid everything and get to the top. Okay, we'll try. Yeah, you have like an actual health bar for this, which is interesting. Yeah, it's like.
How erratic is it dropping stuff?
Yeah, I mean, it's a cool it's a cool idea, but like, man, this is like it's
dropping shit so erratically.
Yeah, God. I do not remember being a fan of this. And like,
it's probably basically a maze of some sort.
Yeah, pretty much. And there's also the fact that, like, I don't know,
can you jump over them?
I don't think you can. Yeah. Or I can just get stuck. That also works too.
Let's try another way around.
The concept for this isn't bad, but like, God. Like, this is... Like, what is this? Like, how the hell am I supposed to get enough time to get around that? I can't... Okay. Yeah. This is awful. I don't...
Please tell me we only have to do this once.
I hope so. Like, is this even... I don't even know what the one is.
Maybe you're supposed to time it.
Okay, that works.
I mean, you can move relatively fast.
Yeah, that is true. What the heck is this... Okay, that's just...
All right. Again. Yeah, I think it's relying on your fast movement.
Yeah.
They're blinking.
How? Okay. Like, you wanna chill out a little bit?
I know that's what the dart. But I know that's what the dart traps. By the way, it always switches rows.
I'll try this one.
I'm very sorry for laughing, by the way.
No, I get it. It's...
I mean, it is really funny seeing Spyro just dropping like...
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna have to go to the left. It's too... Oh my god. Move.
I wish the camera was fixed up.
Yeah, that would help.
Okay, the top one can't hurt you at all.
Yeah. No! What? Okay. Nice sound, by the way.
I can't hear it. What is it going like? Ugh.
It's going to... I don't know, it's like, I can't do the sound, it's like a weird or something. I don't like how close these spiders are.
I don't like how these spiders look.
Yeah, they're kind of like...
go right, keep going right. I don't think up's the right way here.
Good.
We're gonna go around, spider.
Yeah, when I see like big fuzzy spiders like that, I just kind of get like, ugh.
All I think is Rayman 2. You know the spider I'm thinking about.
Dun 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 dun. Oh, I don't. What the theme goes? I can't move. Yeah. This is a. This is a. Okay. Please. Fantastic.
The body glitched. It wasn't gonna drop at all. Wait.
Ugh.
No. Back on the wall.
I can't. Why? Wait, why?
No, well, because you can't just move left?
No.
Oh, can you just wall jump across?
Oh, I can do that, okay.
Now get all the way to the left. And, okay, let's go right this time from the spiders.
I hope they don't chase me.
I think they're just patrolling.
Enough of that.
Yeah, let's go right from this one. Go.
Just go up, just go up. Left. Left. No.
Okay. Almost there, almost right.
Did it? No! Let me move! Is that it?
That looks like it is it.
Okay, please. I don't...
Oh, what are you doing?
There better not be a rat.
I have found the elevator.
Terrific, Spyro. I've never seen anyone get up here before.
Yeah, because it sucks.
Then how did you get up here?
Oh, that. Well, there's a hidden elevator that
only. Of course there was.
But anyway, you'd have to keep it a secret, but there's not really any treasure up here. I never actually thought that anyone could get to the top.
What? So I did all that for nothing?
Well, I guess I should give you something. It's not much, but I found this dragonfly hiding in my secret elevator. Here, you can have it.
Please don't make me do it again.
He wasn't planning on it, so...
I don't have any more dragonflies to
Okay. Keep. No, I am not doing that again. You do know what fun is, don't you, Spock?
Yeah, not this.
Yeah, anything but playing this game. I'll give it this, it was challenging, but not for the right reasons.
I think it was more of a, yeah, I think that one was supposed to be more of a matter of finding the right way, not like just taking whatever it looks like the fastest path.
Yeah, good. I like the idea of it, but like, man...
Well, let's keep going then. Let's see those rhinox. Let's see those riptox on the lava respawn.
Mm. Yep. I'll just ignore them.
Well, we already got rid of them, so we can ignore them.
What's that? Oops. Okay. Oh.
What'd you do?
Okay, we should be very close to the end.
How many more dragonflies are left here?
Three.
So the ending, the one in the chest,
and wherever
and probably one more in the open.
Yeah. Probably from these guys, or something. I don't know.
So that's probably the ending one. We're not going the right. This is not the right way.
Wait.
It's right from here.
Yeah.
No, you need a supercharge.
I like how there was only like one breakable wall and then that was it.
Yeah, and that was in the thieves' den.
Yeah.
By the way, the invincibility did shit for you.
Yeah.
Because that dinosaur still hurt you, I think. Good, empty room syndrome.
Nice.
Alright, what now?
Miss Spyro, that bad old thief over there stole some.
Oh, this one has one.
Believe that? He stole a biomolecular hologram projector from me. And if you would kindly retrieve it, I will reward you graciously.
Cool. Now we have a... okay, I'm gonna get the gems first.
And also roast these Rhinox.
Yeah.
Alright, cool. now we can end the stage.
Yeah.
Oh god, the timer doesn't go... The timer to watch. I think the timer on this invincibility is shorter.
Oh, man.
Go, he scampers.
Yeah. God, that really doesn't last long, does it?
I'm assuming that that's the end of the level right there.
Yeah. We're gonna be here for a while.
Let's try being more bold and just don't stop.
Oh, come on.
Now!
What is this range?
Whatever it is, we're about to get roasted.
Okay. Yay!
Well, we killed the thief. I wonder if that's enough.
I hope.
Let's see what he says. We're right here, so.
Nice.
Great job, Spyro! I knew you could.
Is Scrappy still here, by the way?
It's a dragonfly I found in the jungle.
Scrappy?
Hey, it's Bonky.
Bonky.
Bonky? Look at Bonky! Scrappy's muted.
Oh.
You know, since I don't care, here's my final thoughts on this game. I used to like it when I was younger, but that's because I was young and stupid. game is shit. Anyways, I had a good day.
You made it! Great job!
It was no sweat.
Efforts, 11 out of 10, worst game ever.
Accept this as a reward.
Better than Xenoblade 3.
Hey, it's Wonky.
Hey, we got Bonky and now we got Wonky.
Yeah, just gonna isolate that audio and just play, put that in any context better than Xenoblade 3.
Careful.
Hey.
That's all the gems?
And we just... Is it just...
And now it should be yep, in the chest.
Just the one in the chest.
And then we can get the fuck out of here.
And never play this... yes.
Wait a minute.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
And it's right over there too, so...
Just do that and then... And then we fight the funny man with the banana mouth.
Banana mouth.
Yes.
You're right. And what's our last dragonfly called?
Cool.
Hey, turn the hammer in there.
Hey, it's Jean-Marc.
Sure, we'll go with that.
Okay. That's a creative one. We're done. Now let's get out of here.
Thank God.
Oh, wait, they couldn't even make it 6,900. God damn it. Man, this game really does suck.
Just go.
Wait a minute. Oh, right. 200 gems. We had to pay money bags gems. That's why we have so few.
Oh, yeah.
Now that makes it even more out of place.
Yeah. We're almost done.
Now let's just go beat Banana Mouth. Scrappy is still alive. The game has killed him.
Seems like it.
Oh my. Speaking of those giant spiders that we saw in the level, there's a one right by my foot.
Oh god.